Viewer discretion is advised.
I hold out my hand. 990 nods at me, and he takes something out of his coat. It looks like a blade of some kind. It's got a sharp edge, at least. Before I have time to ask what is going on, he brought the blade down through my wrist, lightning fast. Hello, everybody. I'm The Rubber. Today, we bring you SCP Foundation Keter Class Object SCP-990. SCP-990, also known as the Dream Man, is a humanoid figure who took shape in a normal human male, dressed in a Cold War-era business suit with a hat. He always appears in the dreams of Foundation personnel. Thus far, no Foundation personnel have encountered 990 in the real world. Presently, there have been no reports of 990 appearing to non-Foundation personnel. SCP-990's existence came to light when several agents discussed having dreams involving a similar individual. Numerous other agents reported dream sightings of an individual matching the description of 990. The first time that SCP Foundation acknowledged 990 as a Keter-leveled threat was after an event later known as Event 990-07. The following was what happened during Event 990-07. An agent failed to report for duty at his assigned time. He was instead found in his quarters, asleep. The agent had been asleep for roughly 18 hours, and all subsequent attempts to wake him were unsuccessful. After a period of time, he was transported to the medical bay. After over 40 hours of sleep, the agent finally awakened in a highly agitated state. He was reportedly ran through the facility, yelling loudly about the end of the world. Even after being heavily sedated, all of his bodily functions remained in a dangerously accelerated state: increased heart rate, high blood pressure, etc. The agent described a man matching the regular appearance of 990. According to a doctor's report, the agent described with great details a series of events that would lead to several tactical nuclear missiles being launched into mid-Europe and Eastern Asia. If this crisis happened, it would ultimately exterminate nearly 98% of the human race and destroyed the human society indefinitely. The agent claimed that the information had been outlined to him by SCP-990 while he was trapped within his dream. A mobile task force was dispatched to eliminate the initial threat that would begin the chain of events. It was successful, and the crisis was averted. However, the agent did not survive his ordeal and died of shock-like symptoms. Since Event 990-07, 990 has appeared to many Foundation personnel and made similar threats. As of yet, no situation on the scale of Event 990-07 has occurred. However, 990 has successfully predicted the deaths of 3 SCP doctors, as well as the destruction of Watch Station Epsilon-38. Any threat made by 990 should be reported to Foundation authorities, regardless of its severity. Foundation personnel are considered free to converse with 990 if he should appear to them, and are encouraged to try to obtain information from the subject regarding himself. Additionally, anyone who can determine whether or not SCP-990 has a corresponding body somewhere in the world will be well rewarded. In spite of being seemingly harmless for most of the time, 990 poses a potential serious risk to the Foundation of releasing information to others via dreams, and so risking to break the Foundation's anonymity. Therefore, 990 is primarily classified as Keter. Due to SCP-990's nature, of which he was currently never seen in real life, no special containment procedure is brought out thus far. Any and all ideas for the containment of 990 are welcome, regardless of who suggests them. The following is an interview conducted between a SCP doctor and SCP-990. Although the interview was not recorded until the doctor awoke, but his memory has historically been highly accurate and reliable. In the interview, 990 called himself Tony when introduced, but then changed his mind and called himself Richard. And when asked about the unfortunate events he predicted involving the Foundation, he replied, "I'm not the bad guy here. It is SCP." The doctor replied in doubt, "There is no SCP with that designation, and there won't be for some time." "Well, Of course not. She hasn't even been born yet, much less classified by your foundation. 990 answered with a mysterious look on his face. The below report is written by a SCP doctor. He called it the Standard Dream Report. He filed the following report and forwarded it to the director of Site-17. The report was subsequently transmitted to Overwatch Command. SCP-990 is dressed in the same suit, looking the same as ever. I recognize him immediately. He's the clearest element in any dream he visits. His face changes a lot from dream to dream, but this time it is changing from one moment to the next. I attribute it to the high stress of the past couple of days. He tells me he's going to show me some things. I feel apprehension, and I wonder what burnout ruin he is going to show me. Because that has to be what this is about, right? Our time has come, and this is going to be what awaits us. I try to wake up, but I can't do it. And it feels like I'm sitting at the bottom of a pool, and I can't make myself to go to the surface. I don't think I've felt panic like that in a dream before. 990 shakes his head. I can't tell if it's him keeping me here, or if it's the dream itself. We have never been able to figure out what kind of control he has. He says,
I am going to guide you, but I need something of you first.
And he points at my left hand. It's a dream, right? Even with all of the things we've encountered in this field, I've never seen anyone harmed in that way. I hold out my hand. 990 nods at me, and he takes something out of his coat. It looks like a blade of some kind. It's got a sharp edge at least. Not a knife, more like something from a lawnmower or some piece of industrial machinery. Before I have time to ask what is going on, he's brought the blade down through my wrist, lightning fast. I look at my hand, terrified, and I'm sure that it's going to fall off, and blood is going to start spraying any second. But nothing happens. I stare in shock for a few seconds. The pain is real, but I am afraid to move my arm because my hand is going to fall off if I do. 990 looks sympathetic, and he tells me that I can move my hand. Then he says,
we are out of reach of 001 now, and we can talk.
I wiggle my fingers, and they work like they should, but my hand is numb. The feeling is disconcerting, yet the sensation of panic from earlier is gone. Things feel more like normal now, except for my hand. He looks at me. He's got my face now. I get the impression that I am someone else now. Feels like a woman, but I am not certain. Identity shifts a little as we talk. He tells me that he can give me 3 revelations before 001 finds him again. Suddenly, we're sitting outside, in the night air, under the stars. There are 9 moons in the sky, varying sizes and phases. I'm in a child's body, but he's still me. He finally speaks, holding up one finger.
You are not in your proper place, he says.
I ask him what that means. Me, personally? The Foundation? Mankind? He ignores me. He raises a second finger.
05-2 is absolutely correct, and she is disastrously wrong.
The reference to specific Foundation personnel is unnerving. I start to speak, but I can tell he is not going to listen. The third finger, the third revelation. He leans in close to me.
This is the trickiest one, he tells me.
He asked me to commit this one to memory above all others, and so I have for this report. This is the last thing he said to me before I woke up.
The primary mover behind what we know as SCP-001, above all other things, is love.
That was when I awoke at my workstation.
Remember to check out my new animation channel, The Rubber Talks, where I share my life story, thoughts, and opinions. Just click on the link in the description to enter the Rubber's world. Before we end this video, we are proud to present these incredibly sweet pieces of fan art. A big thank you to all of you. You can now send us your fan art, and we will be more than happy to show off your best art piece in our next video. Check out our description below on how to submit. I hope you enjoyed today's video. Which SCP do you want to see in the next video, and why it is interesting? Let us know in the comment below. We will draw your story and share it with the world. Don't forget to click like, subscribe to the channel, and hit the bell. Please share it to your friends if you like this video. Thank you so much for watching, and we will see you in the next video. Bye-bye!